In our Mad About series of films, we've introduced you to people who are mad about vintage tractors, ancient earth movers and classic plant. This time, we'd like you to meet enthusiasts at the Casterton Working Days near Stamford in Lincolnshire who are mad about vintage harvesting. Whoever you talk to about vintage harvesting machinery, one name will crop up, that of Ron Knight, and his reasons for being mad about the subject go back more than half a century.
I mean, I was a young lad and me and father went to see the chaps taking the Massey 21 out of the box on a local farm, and all these farmer boys round it, and the only thing they could think was any good of it was the box to put in the garden, a shed or something like that. But they didn't like it, because if you imagine the amount of manpower you want for harvesting thing on a big farm, and then the combine will come and put them all out of work, you see. And it's the same old thing, because that happened with the binders, because they had to lock the binders up at night so they didn't break them, you see. And you can understand it. And that's happening today, isn't it?
But most of the old equipment just got scrapped. What was it that got Arthur Hinch involved in trying to keep some of it in working order?
It was at the time when people weren't collecting this stuff, and he said it'll go for scrap. You know, in the early days we were all considered a bit foolish for collecting this old iron, but I think time's proved us probably not quite so daft as we look. Yeah.
Over the last few years, Casterton has seen a remarkable range of harvesting machinery, and we've selected some of the best examples for you. But how far back do you go? Plenty of people still use a sickle or a scythe, but the mechanisation of harvest probably began with the sail reaper. It replaced the scythe, but still left the rest of the work to do. Each sweep of the sails lays down just enough for a sheaf, but someone still has to bind it before it can be stacked or moved.